Hey, we've been seeing some rain too, but not from a tropical system. Look outside Thomasville. Got a couple of views of Thomasville. We'll catch a train one way or the other with now two views on the tracks. But what a beautiful day we got there in Davidson County. As we look at the rest of the Piedmont, we got warm weather, but it's cooling off for some. At the airport, Piedmont Triad is 77 now. East northeast wind blowing at 17, so the front is pushed through. 86 was our high today, 68 our low this morning. You can see off to the east, it gets even cooler up around Yanceyville and Danville, and Henderson just dropped into the 60s too. So three communities there in the 60s, while off to the southwest, we got 80s to near 90, and the heat index just a few degrees warmer than that. So that cold front hasn't helped them out yet, but the front's sliding down from the northeast and got a little shower activity and thunderstorm activity northwest, and we got some also down to the south and east. As we look at the threat, it's a marginal threat for anything severe, so that's very low, but nonetheless it's certainly a possibility. The main threats we're looking at would be from wind and potentially some flooding if you get a heavier shower or storm to sit on top of a spot for a long enough period of time. Here's a look now at radar again. You see some warnings are out down to the south near Sanford, back into parts of Moore County, and also back down to the south of Raleigh, down towards Sampson County. Right in here, we got a little thunderstorm here. We'll have to watch this because this could become a severe storm. If it does, it would be a threat for wind, but you can see the hail with that, or not the hail, the lightning strikes showing up with this just south of South Bend, as this is going to be going through the western parts of Forsyth County. Randolph County looking pretty good. Got a little bit of action down in Moore County as well. The front that's bringing this chance is going to be down to our south tonight, and because of that, we get a northeast wind tomorrow. We'll still have the chance for a couple of showers, but don't expect a lot. But do expect to be a cooler day. We'll be in the low to mid 70s tomorrow. The heat and the humidity will be held back at bay for a day before it charges back in here starting Wednesday, and for the rest of the week, you're going to feel it. We're going to bounce back real fast in the heat department. 82 degrees at the beach tomorrow, 86 degrees Wednesday. Chance of showers is there each of those days. And the mountain forecast, 68 tomorrow, back to 80 on Wednesday, and both of those days, the mountains stand the chance for a shower. Here in the Piedmont tonight, showers are likely for most of us. They won't be constant, but there will be a chance through the evening, and the thunderstorm chance is greater the farther south and west you go for the next couple of hours. And then overnight down to 63, mainly showers, thunderstorm possible in the south closer to the front. Tomorrow will be cloudy. It'll be a cooler day with a few showers. High temperature, only 73 degrees. And here's a look at your 7-day forecast, and you can see that what we've got going on right now. I'm looking at a little statement just came in, so I can tell you about that too. All right, looking at our extended forecast, we've got upper 80s expected for high temperatures for Wednesday, back to 90 degrees on Thursday and Friday, and also Saturday, 89 degrees on Sunday, and 92 degrees on Monday. Chances for showers and storms after tomorrow's showers really does drop off between 25% and 30%. And as I was walking over here, I heard the tone. I checked.